Well, you have about 10 weeks left and your life is about to change. Unless you're coming here late, then you have 9. Cue the fire. And if you're like, what the hell are you talking about, Bravo? You have about 69 days left to start preparing. Now, I know this. You know when they tell you something like that? Remember that? I don't know if I can say it. I'm going to say it. Event 2, Earth 1, there was that exercise. It was a global exercise. You had the gates, right? Sorry, you got to be careful on the YouTubes because sometimes they catch certain words. I don't know how they don't take care of all the spammers, though. But boy, oh boy, do they just have me locked down for everything else. But anyways, this was about, this event went on about 4 months prior to all hell breaking loose. And I guess we'll call it this. We'll call it caps. We're basically capping everyone. And you had all the elites there, and now then they started denying it. They're like, no, we didn't do anything like that. And let me just be 100% accurate. Bill, who now owns the most farmland, my gosh, I think you need some food. I'll get to that in just a second. Remember, now you have 9. We didn't simulate this. We didn't practice. So both the health policies and economic policies, we find ourselves in uncharted territory. And now we have analysts warning you. Here it is. We have warns world has just 10 weeks left. You're like, Bravo, you lined it out. Because the story was from a couple days ago. So I figured we would drop it to 9 weeks of wheat supplies left in storage. And now everyone that's producing stuff that you need to eat and survive and the rest of the world are like, we're keeping it. So basically with no food and nothing in the barn, they're like, whatever's going in, it's for our people. And they're saying it's these conditions are worse than 2007, 2008. And then, wait, we have the lowest grain inventories levels the world has ever seen. But also know that the same people that create the problems are the ones with the solution. See, that's what you do. You create a problem, then you're like, oh, trust us. We're gonna fix that. Love that logo every time I see it. That's what they're talking about right now in Davos. Davos 2020 IMF chief. She urges action on food crisis, and it's all Russia's fault. So let's go get them. I mean, first the world problems were the orange guy. That was the problem. But now that he's out, they're like, okay, whose fault is it now? And now they're saying Russia has just made so much money.
You know, shocking reading, saying that revenue from Russia from oil increased 50% since the start of the year.
No! You see, now they're making so much more money, and we got to go after them. And with all this, and we have a breaking banner. I love those. This is my, I get these, like CNBC, they're like, look, Bravo, you got to talk about that. Ukraine warns, if just in case you wanted to know how long this food crisis is going to be, so make sure you have some, multi-year, and it is going to be very difficult. But also, I'll talk about the stocks rise. After Fed signals further rate hikes. Actually, they're signaling more. They're like, nope. And the Dow goes up. Wait, I'm so confused. I thought with more of a hawkish Fed, right, the market should crumble. Why'd the market go up today? I bet you bonds must have sold off today too. Well, why don't we just take a quick peek? What market closed? Here we go. S&P 500 up, Dow up. Let's do U.S. Sorry. Hang Seng. We got New York stock. Yeah, look at all this up. Well, the bond must have just sold off today. Well, looky there. It was up almost 0.5%. Probably pull back a little bit tomorrow. Up 0.40, finding that bottom and rising. See, bond prices, bonds and yields. Because when everyone runs to bonds, yields go down. When everyone sells all it's always opposite. And for some reason, I seem to always be on the other side of these trades. I always might look a little crazy, but then we dig into it. And yes, you can trade wheat too. I can show you the chart on that one. Because remember, at the end of the day, the charts will tell you what the market is going to say. And actually, looking at wheat prices, I turned a couple things on for you so you can understand. I drew a little trend line, okay? We're moving up. You definitely want to take profit. When you guys get above, see that? It's probably red to you. I'm getting a new screen. It's brown on this screen. I'm just saying. When it hits 9 and it turns red, you need to be taking your profit. And that's what happens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And what happens? It falls down. We actually came right here. You see this blue trend line? This one right there. We'll probably more likely get above it. But MACD, signs of a little sell-off right there. So we will see. And if you're like, wheat, this is a great swing. I say store it. This is not your trade. If you're swing trading this, you are above the 200. That is good. You just need to wait for a beatdown. So I am not telling you to enter this trade. Different ways that you can trade it. This one on your last swing trade. Good swing trade though, right? You get the beatdown, comes up from right here. And then that's, oh, hey, 16%. And if you're like, wow, how do you know all of this? It's in my, all of this is in the course. Actually, in the course, I would say definitely you have to exit there. If you were smart enough, okay, and you turned on, you know, certain indicators, you're like, I should take profit. Sometimes you guys email, you're like, I'm up so much, should I take profit? Don't ever email me if you should take profit. The answer is yes. But Bravo, I want to make as much money as humanly possible. It doesn't make you happy in the end anyways. But I will tell you what will make you happy. 75 off, link in the description. That's if you want to swing trade or if you want to do the crypto thing, all combined with these little lines. And also if you're like, Bravo, you need to put your money where your mouth is. I want to see your trades. Hey, look at that, troll. Because of you, I have to do that. Every single morning, this was on my Bravo's watch list. Link in the description. SNY. And guess what we are doing? So even when the market is selling off and everyone's like, oh my gosh, well, I told you that this is going to happen. Also, I am telling you now, the people that are in this course, well, that would be my Bravo's watch list. Look, do you see the 9 count? You might want to take some paper trade money off the table. And I'll tell you, trading just repeats and repeats. Same thing. Do you see this? 9. Oop, we get one candle above. You're up, you know, 8%. That's it. Or what you can do is just wait for it to come down below that. Your call. That's up to you. So you can either buy wheat, store wheat, prep wheat, trade wheat, whatever you want to do. And then I even show you which way it's going to go. Because the world is saying, wait, we make it. We don't want to give it to you. That's basically what's happening because they foresee. And so does all the, you know, World Economic Forum. I don't even like finishing sentences because I know the algos are like, oh, we got to put that video aside. We don't like that word. As food protectionism, they're protecting their food spreads. India limits sugar. Oh, looks like we might be losing some weight here. Exports, Malaysia halts chicken sales. So worldwide, people that have stuff are like, no, we want it. We're going to protect our own. Sugar, protect our own. Wheat, protect our own. Oil, they just made some money. We got chicken. I didn't know. Chick-fil-A, you might be hurting. Actually, one of my favorites is this right here. And then you ask them for more, put more honey on that. Oh my gosh. So if you ever want to gain a whole lot of weight, you could get a tray of them and just gorge yourself. But basically everywhere that I turn news in regards to the news and food, it's not good. So let this be a warning to you. You should probably have something. I'm just saying, your call. With food prices climbing, check. I mean, worst case scenario, oh, I remember when I bought that bag for 10 bucks. It's 100 bucks now. Crazy. It'll be like silver prices someday or gold prices. When that thing, when that falls apart, you won't be able to touch it. The UN is warning of crippling global shortages. And I know a lot of you are like, Bravo, you keep bringing the problems. Well, I tell you what the problems are. I tell you about if you choose to protect your wealth and if you want to profit from it, that is up to you. But you can buy it, trade it, store it, whatever. But in the end, it always comes down to this. This is the system, fourth turning. And guess how it always ends? 100% of the time, it's war. My apologies. For some reason, I guess it solves things. But then you have rebirth. And just to let you know, in the fourth turning, good little page turner. It started in 07-08. That was the beginning, and you're looking at 20 years. So we're starting to get towards the end. We probably have about 8 years left, and then it will not be good, but then it will be good. So just make sure that you can make it through the crisis, because it's going to get very bad. You kind of witnessed a little bit of it about a year ago, a little over a year ago, you know, the riots and all of that. Wait until people are hungry. You do not know a riot on a full tummy. Riots happen with an empty tummy. And I know most of your tummies probably gained about 10 pounds over the lockdown. So maybe you have something to shed. And I actually shed quite a bit. I shed everything. I got out of everywhere. California, got out of the kids, I ran over here to Texas. Yeehaw! By the way, hey, everyone in California, sorry about those comments. I can't get rid of them. You're also running out of a few things. It's called water. Your water is going away. Governor Newsom warns California, mandatory restrictions, worsening drought. And being the dictator he is, I mean, unless you want to delete the word tater, Gavin Newsom, he has some aggressive actions. And I can see you guys in the comments section. We have a solution. There's problem, solution. Solution, get in car, drive. Or not. But don't sit there and complain about it. And let me give you a little warning sign. You're probably going to want food, okay? Check, make sure, or like a bug out something. Because when it goes bad, it's going to get bad. A little fresh water source. That way you can kind of sit back and just like, okay, I'm ready for it. Let it all play out. Then we have, then it's good times. Let the good times roll. Kind of like being in California with the earthquakes. My family, oh my gosh, it's the worst ever. I'm like, this is cool. I would actually be the one jumping on my balance board or my one wheel, you know, trucking around. I'm like, look at this. I can bunny hop this thing. But you guys already knew. I'm a little crazy. And that is why you subscribed. Yes, I remembered. And oh, thanks. Thank you. Bravo under my desk. If you could like, save the channel, helps it out. Love you guys. Prepare, and I will see you, tomorrow, because I work every single day of my life.